Welcome to the Forensic Financialist, where we simplify business and leadership challenges and choose the road that leads to wisdom and excellence. We discuss tough issues facing business and figure out easy-to-implement solutions. Using the rearview mirror approach, we look in the rearview to move towards a brighter future. Here's your host, Jeff Newkirk.
Welcome to the Forensic Financialist, where we aim to improve your business and help you grow both personally and professionally. I'm your host, Jeff Newkirk. Today, we have a very special treat for you. We have world-renowned, best-selling author, business guru, business coach, consultant, Dorie Clark. Now, Dorie Clark helps individuals and companies get their best ideas heard in a crowded, noisy world. She has been named one of the top 50 business thinkers in the world by Thinkers 50 and was honored as the number one communication coach in the world at the Marshall Goldsmith Coaching Awards. She's a keynote speaker and teaches for Duke University's Fuqua School of Business and Columbia Business School. She is the author of Entrepreneurial You, which was named one of Forbes' top five business books of the year, as well as Reinventing You and Stand Out, which was named the number one leadership book of the year by Inc. magazine. A former presidential campaign spokeswoman, Clark has been described by the New York Times as an, quote, expert at self-reinvention and helping others make changes in their lives, end quote. She is a frequent contributor to Harvard Business Review and consults and speaks for clients such as Google, Yale University, and the World Bank. She is a graduate of Harvard Divinity School, a producer of a multiple Grammy-winning jazz album, and a Broadway investor. You can download her free Entrepreneurial You self-assessment workbook at dorieclark.com/entrepreneur. Wow, what a bio. Dorie Clark, it's great to have you as a guest on the Forensic Financialist. Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you, Jeff. I'm glad to be here hanging out with you.
Man, multiple Grammy-winning jazz album. Tell me a little bit about that, if you don't mind. That just sort of, you know, you've done it all, right?
Well, thank you. Yeah, the album, which is a great one, I recommend it for people who like jazz, is called Presidential Suite by the Ted Nash Big Band. And it won two Grammys a few years back. It was a really exciting project to be part of. But for me, actually, one of the most interesting takeaways is I, of course, try to walk the talk. And so for me, the way that I got involved with this project, it was certainly not because I'm a jazz musician or I'm that especially encyclopedically knowledgeable about jazz. It was through my network. And so one of the things that you know from my recognized expert course that I teach, yes, which is about how do you become a recognized expert in your field or in your company.
Awesome course, by the way. Awesome course.
Oh, thank you, Jeff. Well, one of the key pillars is building a strong network because, you know, I think for a lot of us, there's a tendency to kind of be a lone wolf or want to do everything on our own and, you know, not ask for any favors or things like that. But the truth is, we get exposed to opportunities through the people around us. And there was a guy, it turned out, that I had done some favors for, and I knew him because one of the hats that he wore was he was a fellow business author. But as it happened, he also was very heavily involved in the jazz world. And when it came time for him to essentially want to repay the favor, he's like, hey, I have this great project I'm involved in. Would you like to get involved? I really think it's going somewhere. And it turns out it did.
That is so awesome. So any other albums in your future or...
You know, we'll have to see.
We'll see how it goes.
What I've been busy working on the last couple of years is I am part of a training program. I graduated from this run by BMI, the music publishing company. And so I have spent the past couple of years learning to become a musical theater lyricist. So that's what I've been working on.
Wow. Wow. That's awesome. That's awesome, Dorie. So tell us, how did you first get started as a coach and consultant?
So the way
where
that
did
I
it all begin?
Yeah. Thank you, Jeff. The way I got started was I actually had in my 20s this series of kind of tragically abortive careers. I was a newspaper reporter and I got laid off, and then I worked on political campaigns and they all lost, and you know, things were not really breaking my way.
Perseverance, right?
Thank you. Yes. So I ended up running a nonprofit for a couple of years. And it was during the time that I ran the nonprofit that I had this sort of realization, which is, oh my goodness, all the things that I'm learning here are basically the same as it would be if I was running a small business. You know, I mean, just it being a nonprofit and that we got our money in slightly different ways, but you still had to be profitable enough to keep going. And I thought, you know, I could do this myself. I could have my own business. And so I decided to pull together what I had learned about marketing and communications and things from my time in politics, because I was doing political communications there through my time as a journalist. And I decided to start a consultancy around marketing and publicity and things like that. Mm-hmm. And that was mm-hmm. how it got started.
Wow. Awesome. Well, I would say that they could probably still use you today on the presidential campaign trail. That's just my opinion.
Thank you, my man.
Okay. Being a part of the Rexer community myself, it has been just a great experience, really has. I've met new people, been networking, and most of all, learning from one of the best thought leaders in the industry. So thank you.
Oh, I appreciate it, Jeff. I mean, and Rexer is, you know, for those who are not super up on our cool kid lingo, that's the term that folks in the recognized expert course that I run use to refer to themselves. It's a really fantastic, tight-knit community of about now 500 plus very interesting and accomplished professionals.
Yeah, we just use the term Rexer, it just comes naturally to us. I mean, we're on the, you know, Facebook page and going back and forth and helping each other. So supportive. It's such a supportive group. But how has developing the Rexer program impacted you and your business?
It has actually been really powerful, Jeff, to create the Recognized Expert course and community. You know, we always say in the world of sort of marketing and product development and things like that, oh, well, you know, you should listen to your audience and you should create things your audience wants and things like that. Like, we all know it intellectually. But so often what tends to happen is we do the same thing that kind of people have always done, which is you cook up some idea and you fall in love with it. And then you go off and invest probably way too much time and effort into it so that it becomes this like too big to fail kind of thing, except sometimes it does fail and it becomes really devastating because you realize too late, oh gosh, no one really wanted that or nobody saw the value in that, which is a terrible fate to befall you. And it is just so incredibly powerful. I did not realize that this would happen, you know, as I was creating the Recognized Expert community, but to have a group of people that, I mean, it is a lot of effort. You know, I mean, I'm in there interacting with
sure.
people. Yeah.
Which really, I mean, that blows me away that we're in there on the Facebook page, but then there's Dorie, you know, also posting and commenting. I'm like, wow, where do you have all the time?
Oh, well, thank you. Well, so yeah, I mean, it's definitely, you know, sort of an, you know, quote unquote, like an extra thing that you have to do, but it's so incredible because what it means is it has dramatically shaped my business because I never have to feel like, gosh, I don't know what people want. You know, I have this very engaged audience of people that I am in such constant touch with. I feel like it has really been transformational because it's given me a sense into the world of the people that I am hoping to serve so that I can see what they care about and where they're having trouble and where the sticking points are and things like that. So that if I am, you know, updating a course to try to make it better, or if I'm launching a new product or things like that, I can actually see from interacting with people what would be helpful and what would not. And it just takes a lot of the guesswork out of things, and it makes it an incredibly worthwhile investment, I think, you know, hopefully on both ends.
Oh, for sure. And I could tell you just from my own experience at being in the Recognized Expert Program, first of all, there's a lot of content. You know, I've been through other courses, and I'm sure you've seen tons of them online and elsewhere, but the Recognized Expert Program that you've put together is full of very useful content that you can apply right away. I mean, and that's what I love about it. And you're so genuine and you're so authentic that you're like, here it is. This is what you need to do, and go do it. And, you know, I appreciate that. I appreciate that. So lots of content, great stuff. Other thing I would comment on the Recognized Expert Program with regard to the Facebook page, I changed the name of my company several weeks ago. And so I wanted to get a new logo. And I reached out to you, and you said, well, hey, use the Facebook page. I'm like, yeah, great idea. And that's how I got my new logo.
That's
great.
There
was so much great feedback. It is such a supportive group. So,
how many people weighed in out of curiosity?
Oh my gosh, I think it was around 30 to 40 people.
That's amazing. So you basically had a focus group.
Yeah, I mean, I just put it out there. I was like, hey, I changed the name of my company. I mean, I'm doing the whole, I got to be a recognized expert of my own, you know, get my name out there. Here are my logos that have been developed. Pick one that you think is best. All kinds of feedback.
That's so great. Because, you know, you might have a preference, or I might have a preference, but you know, you just never know if it's in tune with the market or if it's sort of idiosyncratic for some weird reason. But when you have 40 people telling you, like, Jeff, pick the blue one or whatever it is, like, you're like, right, oh, okay.
Right. Yeah, well, and, you know, Jeff would have picked the yellow one, right? I mean, you know, my choice was totally different. So thank you so much for that that direction, and it worked out great. So just another plug for the Rexer program.
That's fantastic. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. So I have your books.
I can see them. Oh my goodness. I love the array. Thank you.
Sure. So I have to admit, Standout is my favorite. It directly applies to me right now as I try to build my business and a following as well. In the last chapter, you discussed the need to take action. Have there been times when you questioned whether you were on the right path? And what advice would you give those who are ready to call it quits because, you know, they've just had a struggle? And this year has been a struggle for many, many people.
That is for sure. That is for sure. I mean, we all can war game all kinds of possibilities. And, you know, I think everybody recognizes, like, oh, you know, there's market downturns sometimes, things slow down sometimes. I don't think anybody thought, oh, the entire world's going to come to a standstill for, you know, however many months. I mean, it's just
even in the movies, if there was a movie that was out there that showed the world coming to a stop, you would say, oh, well, that would never happen.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. it's just crazy the circumstances that we have found ourselves in year. So people have had to overcome a lot. That is really true. Well, you know, your question, Jeff, brings me back to a time right before my first book came out. My first book was Reinventing You, and it was released in the spring of 2013. And I had started my business about 7 years prior in 2006, and I had managed to do, you know, pretty well in terms of getting it going and getting a stream of clients and things like that. I mean, I think like a lot of consultants, it was a little bit feast or famine. I didn't necessarily have the most consistent pipeline of business in the world. So I was always thinking, like, okay, I know the business is going to come from somewhere. I'm just kind of not sure where, but it would come. And a really strange thing happened starting in the late fall of 2012 and kind of going into early 2013. And that is that just business really dried up. And there was not a discernible reason that I could find for it exactly. It wasn't that I was doing some new thing or I wasn't doing something that I used to do. I just couldn't quite figure it out. But the pace of new client inquiries that I was used to just suddenly dramatically dropped off. And I felt like there was nothing new coming in. And I was starting to get worried. I was just
stressful. Stressful. Yeah,
it's a terrible feeling for anybody.
It is a terrible feeling.
Yeah. So, you know, under those circumstances, I mean, I always try to be at least as honest with myself as I can. And so I thought, all right, well, I mean, if this continues like indefinitely, obviously I'll probably have to like go get a job or do something. But at the time, my first book was about to be released. And so I just kind of made a calculation and I said, you know what? This may or may not happen, but probably there's at least, you know, decent reason to believe that when the book comes out, there will be a flurry of attention or publicity or whatever. Mm-hmm. And hopefully that will drive new business. And so what I need to do is just double down on that and, try to do everything I can to get as much publicity as possible around the book launch to take advantage of it and test that hypothesis, you know, and, mm-hmm. and it may or may not be true, but let's see, because it could be true. And that's kind of the best hope that I have at this point. Mm-hmm. So, as it happened, I mean, fortunately when the book came out, it did get a good amount of publicity and I was able, you know, I started not only to get the spigot turned on again about consulting inquiries, but I started to get speaking inquiries, which I had never really gotten before. You know, all of a sudden when you have an actual book, oftentimes people will suddenly start to think of you as a viable speaker for conferences and things like that. So that became a new source of income for me. So things really turned around at that point, but there was that moment where it was kind of this dark time of like, oh geez, you know, I don't know why this is happening and I don't know what to do to fix it exactly. So yeah. I think the lesson that I learned from it is, you know, I mean, sometimes you don't know and sometimes there's not a lot that you can do to control it, but all I did and all I think one probably can do is develop a hypothesis and just lean into it and test it. And, you know, if it hadn't have worked, I probably would have had to fold in some capacity, but instead I'm like, you know what, let's go all in on the book. And, that ended up paying off.
That's awesome. And what a great book. And from that, you're the top 50 business thinkers in the world.
Thank
wow.
you.
I mean, that's really great. And I remember in one of your books, you stated that you couldn't get a speaking engagement at the local chamber of commerce. And, you know, that really hit home with me because I'm like, yeah, you know, why can't you're doing it for free, right? You'll bring lunch. And until you get recognized, it's going to be tough. And you persevered and you made it happen. So great.
Thank you.
Great job. Good for you. Good for you.
Yeah, I think, I mean, part of the reason, Jeff, that I like to tell stories like that is that it's just, it's so common. And
it hits home.
Yeah, I work with so many folks. I mean, whether they're, you know, private coaching clients or folks who are in the recognized expert community, I just hear this all the time. And, you know, and I felt it myself. It's just so dispiriting when you get these like, you know, just these like fucking know-it-all bureaucrats. And they're just like, no, well, we're looking for someone who's a well-known speaker or, you know, like whatever they're trying to pull, like some little power struggle kind of thing. And you just have to resist that. I mean, we will always lose if we fold and if we succumb and if we somehow believe them and their petty bullying. We have to have the confidence to push back and let them know, like, all right, fine, you do what you want now, but you know what, in 3 years or 5 years you're gonna just fucking live to regret that.
Dorie, that's what I love about you, man. I mean, you just This is how it is. And you just have to, you know, persevere, and those people will regret. I love that. I love that. And
thank
it's true. It's true, right?
Yeah.
I mean, because it happens all the time, and we can so easily just, you know, get down and put our head in the sand and say, okay, well, I guess it's not going to work out. No, it will work out. You just have to persevere.
I literally want everyone who has ever turned me down for anything, I want them, like, on their deathbed to feel like the person who rejected the Harry Potter series. Like, that is what I want. I want that for me, and I want that for you, and I want that for all of our, you know, hardworking, smart people. I want smart, wonderful people to get their ideas heard, and I do not want them to be stopped by just the petty obstructionists that are out there.
And because sometimes they just stop you because they can.
Yeah.
No real good reason. It's just because they have the power to do that. And that what bothers me more than anything is when you see somebody that's working hard, trying to do the right thing, and they're getting stopped, and then they're just totally, you know, deflated. And yeah. I mean, they just don't want to go on. And it's like, no, don't be bullied. Do not be bullied. So
that's
obviously
right.
We're both passionate about that.
Absolutely.
So Dorie, tell us about your new book. Excited to read it.
Yes. Well,
tell us about it.
Speaking of the recognized expert community, one of the things, you know, literally as we're taping this, Jeff, you may have seen that over the weekend, I put up a grouping of titles and a grouping of subtitles, and we're basically focus grouping it with the recognized expert community now to kind of home in on what would be most appealing. So I won't reveal the title and subtitle yet because we're still tallying the votes.
Mm-hmm.
But the basic idea, and this is a book that's going to be coming out in the fall of 2021 from Harvard Business Review Press, mm-hmm. it is a book about strategic patience and about how to play the long game. So it's really, it kind of ties in with our conversation, actually, right? It's like, it's for every person who's ever been turned down by their local chamber of commerce. You know, it's how do you take all of the just adversity, all of the slog that we find in our career, and how do we leverage that and how do we harness that so that we can be triumphant and get what we need done in the world. And so I am sharing, you know, my strategies and tips and advice that I've practiced myself, that I've seen through, you know, just hundreds of coaching clients that I've worked with. But it's really kind of giving tools and a framework for people so that even in those moments when you might doubt yourself, when you might compare yourself to other people, that you are able to harness the fortitude and the resilience that you need to keep pressing forward so that you can be triumphant in the end.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Rise up, you know, and don't be bullied. Keep going. Yeah. I can't wait to read it. I know it's going to be an awesome book, and I'll add it to my library.
Thank you. I love it. You're getting a darn good collection there.
Yeah. Well, I'm working at it. So what's the future? I know that the book's coming out in the fall of 21, but what does the future hold for Dorie Clark? What do you see as happening next year, 5 years, 10 years? What's the perfect scenario for you?
Yeah, thank you very much. Well, you know, above and beyond the book, of course, which I'm excited about, I have definitely been continuing to emphasize online courses. I think COVID, you know, if it's taught us nothing else, it's that having resources that people can tap from around the world, asynchronous, and available anytime, is really valuable as a model moving forward. And so I launched my Recognized Expert course and community in 2016. So that's been growing over time. I also have done a lot of work with LinkedIn Learning. I filmed two courses for them right as the pandemic broke out. I've just recorded another two. I'm still working on another one. So there's going to be five more through the end of the year that I'm doing with them. So
very
that's going to be a piece of it. Yeah, thank you. And then I really want to write a show for Broadway. So that's what I've been training up to do.
That's awesome. That is awesome. Well, I can't wait to hear about that because I know it's going to be a great one.
Thank you so much.
Dorie, this has been wonderful. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule. And I know you could have been doing a million other things other than talking to me today, but I really appreciate it. This has been great. How can people learn about you and the Recognized Expert Program? Where can they find that information?
Thank you so much, Jeff. Well, it's awesome to get the chance to talk with you. One resource that I will suggest to people, because of course you mentioned this was your favorite book of mine, is there is a standout self-assessment that people can get. And it's pretty comprehensive. It's a 42-page self-assessment that helps walk you through and really think about what is the special sauce that you have in your professional life? How can you really encapsulate the value that you bring to in a way that can help you articulate it and make it clear to other people? And if you're interested in that, you can get it at dorieclark.com/join, J-O-I-N, and download that for free. And people can find out about that. And of course, well, be in touch as we launch future cohorts of the Recognized Expert Program.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, Dorie, again, thank you so much. Appreciate you taking the time. Like I say at the end of every episode, I ask my listeners, suggest that I hope they got at least one nugget of useful information. And I know you gave several nuggets of useful information. So again, thank you. Thank you for taking the time. It's been great. Thank you to Dorie Clark. What a great opportunity it is to speak with you. It's been great. Have a great day. And make tomorrow even better. Thanks, Dorie.
Thanks so much, Jeff.
You've been listening to The Forensic Financialist, where we simplify business and leadership challenges and choose the road that leads to wisdom and excellence. To learn more about Jeff, visit his website at understandablesolutions.com or email Jeff at jeff@understandablesolutions.com. Mentioning this podcast will get you a complimentary discovery session with Jeff. Until next time.